Seeing as Silk Song was delayed, and I didn't have any material to make a video about for over 4 months now, I decided I will share something that was on my mind since the very first trailer. I know it's a clickbaity topic, but I do want to talk about it. Before I say anything, this is a subjective opinion, so I don't want people to get all riled up because of my preference in games. Okay, so now that that's out of the way, we are going to discuss the title of this video. Why I think Silksong will be worse than Hollow Knight. It's much simpler than you think, it all sums down to atmosphere. Even from the trailer, we can already see that Silksong will have a much lighter color scheme than Hollow Knight did, but the biggest difference is that the kingdom that Hornet will be exploring is still alive, unlike Hollow Nest. It is controlled by the curse, but it's still alive. From the trailer we already saw at least 3 towns where NPCs live, and that's already more than Hollow Knight has. There's this dark dock area with a bug that is like a mix of Elderbug and Relic Seeker Lamb. The second area is this village in between the Mossy Grotto and the Bone Bottom, and it's basically the size of the Dirt Mount. And the biggest area of them all is this big city filled with these bell houses. There is probably located somewhere within the Citadel, seeing as the colors match. This city alone includes a quest board, shopkeeper, and multiple floors of NPC houses. It's basically the City of Tears, but if all the bugs were still normal. There could also be one more area, because we also see this, like quest board or job board, whatever you want to call it, and it also might be in some kind of town. So, why is this a problem for me? Well, personally, my favorite types of worlds in games are the ones that are basically fucked beyond repair. I like it when I go through a world and I see ruins with small information that describe why the world is the way it is. A great example of this are worlds in Dark Souls, Bloodborne, and Blasphemous. And if you haven't played any of these games and you still don't understand what type of worlds these are, I can also give a great example from a Swedish artist called Simon Stellenhag and his book The Electrical State. It is a book, but it's more about the art than the text. It captures this electrical apocalypse that I can only describe as beautiful and uncomfortable, because it feels so alien but also very similar to our own world. It focuses on over-automatization, brand control, and the destruction that these two things bring with them. But enough about the book, let's get back to the topic of the video. Hollow Knight captures this feeling of hopelessness from the very first area of the game. The second lore tablet in the King's Pass states the following. Higher beings, these worlds are for you alone. Beyond this point, you enter the land of King and Creator. Step across this threshold and obey our laws. Bear witness to the last and only civilization, the Eternal Kingdom, Hollow Nest. You read this and you expect this glorious kingdom that withstood the test of time itself, but what you get instead is a husk, a shell of the kingdom it once was. And the more you play, the more you discover the hopelessness of the situation that the king of this kingdom was in. One day, a plague that started corrupting the bugs of this kingdom has appeared. They tried to neutralize it by force, yet it still spread. So they ran, closing the gates of the capital city in a hopeless attempt to escape the infection. This plan seemed to work at the start, but at the cost of the sanity and lives of the people within the capital. Some bugs started cannibalizing each other because of the lack of food, some of them tried to discover the secret of immortality in a desperate attempt to combat the infection, which led to even more deaths. And even with all these futile attempts to stop the infection from entering the capital, it still snuck its way in through the dreams of the bugs. This time, the king saw there was no running from this thing, so he made a plan to seal the plague within one of his children. And surprisingly, it worked for the time being. But at some point, the shell that was keeping the infection from spreading cracked, and the infection started seeping into the air of the entire kingdom. Forcing the king to abandon his kingdom for the very last time, he transported himself, his castle, and his most loyal of men to a dream world where he would meet his end at the hands of the king's molds and the void inside of them that he himself brought into the castle with him. This is a very short explanation of what happened in the Kingdom of Hollow Nest. There is one more text that perfectly encapsulates the hopeless situation that the Pale King was in. It's a dreamnail dialogue from this big fungal creature. It says, "Pale worm, What good to foresee a demise unavoidable? Even though the king could see into the future, the fall of his kingdom was already determined. And this is exactly why I like Hollow Knight. Even the god that could see the future was killed and his legacy fell to ruin. I like it when I see beauty in destruction that has already occurred. And sometimes, not even destruction, but the sheer emptiness of structures that you can still imagine being full of life. Like the bridges in Crossroads that still have wagons of cargo on them, just sitting there, abandoned. Like the Queen Station where you can still hear the whispers of the bugs that have once traveled there. The failed attempt to build the tram station through Deep Nest. The broken down and overgrown roads of Green Path. All these small details that portray the state of the kingdom make Hollow Knight such a beautiful game. But I doubt that Silksong will bring me this beauty, seeing as the leader of the kingdom is still alive. Okay, maybe not the leader, but something is clearly pulling the strings. Literally. Plus, the whole kingdom still seems to be in relatively great shape, unlike Hollow Nest. There are still bugs mining and providing resources to the Citadel on a regular basis. We see a few workshops that are still in demand, seeing as the fires in the furnaces are still burning. They also have a prison and a judge that are still working. But there is still an area that seems to be quite run down. And there is this windy sand area with one of the last judge's little helpers. In the background we can see some collapsed structures, but that's pretty much it. I mean, the area might be bigger, but one area is still not enough to replace a whole game. And that's pretty much it. I think from a mechanical and graphical standpoint, Silksong will be better than Hollow Knight. I mean, of course, they have much bigger budget now. But for my personal enjoyment, it might fall a bit short comparing to Hollow Knight, but I hope I get proven wrong. Now, I will ask you all, of course, to subscribe and like the video if you enjoyed it. And if you saw any flaws, please make sure to point them out in the comments, especially if I didn't explain something enough, or I didn't express myself correctly, because English is not my first language, so my choice of words might not be the best in some sentences. And that's it for now. I'll see you all when we get some news about Silksong.